going on to my e-comeback? Not really, because that's identified with the Hindu tradition so extremely and exclusively in so many ways. And what we need now is just that which is not identified with any tradition, actually, to help out. But what can be present here? The freshness. Because that's what was present there. And with Ramana Maharshi, that's what was present with Jesus. That's what was there, was freshness, rooted in freshness, untouched by time. That's what was really present, was normalcy. That is normalcy. That can be here. Absolutely, that can be here. Are we somehow being shortchanged because we're not? It's not the return of Jesus or nor Ananda Mayi or something? No. Freshness doesn't shortchange anyone. It doesn't shortchange itself at all. Freedom cannot shortchange itself, does not shortchange itself. So nobody is being shortchanged, actually. Freedom is not rooted in some guru, it's rooted in itself. Freshness is not rooted in time, space, process, and form, some appearance of some guru saying, I am the greatest, I am the ultimate, everything is rooted in me. No, freedom is rooted in itself. Freshness is rooted in itself. Normalcy is rooted in itself. Reality is rooted in itself. All-inclusiveness is rooted in itself. Oneness is rooted in itself. Isness is rooted in isness. And nowhere else, because there is nowhere else. So, full stop in the wow of this instead of the don't try to be clever, spiritually clever with it. See, this is very important what we're helping with here is wow is greater than any spin you can put upon it. Okay. Of course it's possible to put spin on it and try to be spiritually clever, practice spiritual one-upsmanship. But here we say, no. Just stay with the wow. That's superior to spiritual one-upsmanship. Most certainly is. Don't spin the wow at all. Just stay with a wow mind. Stay wow-minded. Stay in wow-mindedness. Now, you may not seem to be so clever, but we're not after cleverness. We're after freshness. And freshness has no need to be clever. It's rooted in itself already. I had these beautiful videos I've done of nature, and it's very mind-blowingly beautiful. But I look for some music to put on them. I tried all sorts of music, and first I watched it silently, and then I put music on. I put Beethoven's Fifth, I put all these beautiful classical, all styles, jazz, rock, metal, gospel, pop, dance, alternative, on and on and on, world, other, and you know what? I said, wow, no, all of that puts spin on it. It's way better to watch it silently and just feel the wow of it. Wow. Sort of reminds me of freshness. There's something, you know, I tried to make it somehow evocative of freshness, rooted in freshness. But I said it's better to not have a soundtrack. It's way better. I experienced this very strongly. Even like Beethoven said, I said, no, that totally interferes. It's trying to take it over. You know, it's spin. You lose the wow of it. You lose the wow of it. So it's better to be quiet, to be silent. We don't need a soundtrack. Freshness doesn't need a soundtrack, actually. It interferes. It detracts. tell from this by Ramana Maharshi. I met him one time when I was body was sleeping. My consciousness met him. He came up to me and said, look, don't worry. You're not rooted in tradition. I said, look, you're rooted in this. Somebody following you. You're sort of rooted in the tradition to some extent. And he said, that's okay. You know, that's okay too. What I did is okay. It helpful. Great. I said, but just you keep working on what you're working on. Don't worry about trying to be rooted in something. Forget it. Yes, you're going to succeed and be very helpful. So don't let it bother your mind at all, okay? And he was, what I felt from it was freshness. Even though he was talking and smiling, the body was, body appearance was there. The freshness of freshness was what I experienced. And it's just like, wow. This is what the freshness is like. I was just like, you can't beat it. That's what I feel. You can't beat this. You cannot beat this. Now, was that quote unquote the tradition of Ramana Maharshi, or was it freshness being freshness? It was freshness being freshness. Which was all that Ramana Maharshi was. Also, freshness being freshness. That's all that freshness can do. Normalcy being normal. But I got this boost saying, don't worry, it's okay that you're not affiliated with some tradition. That's perfectly okay. It's going to be very helpful down the road, is what he says. It's going to be very helpful, actually. And I couldn't see. How can it be helpful? I don't understand. Well, it's still difficult to understand unless there are changes coming in the world, and now we see that this CCC, if you're aware of the CCC and the takeover, the incorporation of this planet by outside influences, extraterrestrial influences, really, and if you're very clear about that, which I certainly am, then you can start to realize, hey, this planet is fundamentally changing, and it is. It's made a marriage, it's gotten married to high technology, which is old-fashioned, is very old-fashioned, is going backwards, is going regressive in many ways. Now, you can always find a silver lining, and you have to, but it's very much regressing, and so it's changing severely, this planet, very, very severely. You won't even, in a while, you won't even recognize, you know, the past and all that. You won't even recognize, you know, the tradition of technology is now the tradition that people are latching onto, thinking maybe this tradition will work. Maybe we can find out a way to some super projection. Yeah, we got the technology, they say. We got the technology to make the projection of guilt work. You know, we have advanced technology that'll make it work. And people say, oh, wow, this is what we need. We got wireless projection. We got, you know, it's all wireless. See, that's your problem. Projecting guilt on bodies that didn't work because it wasn't wireless. We have wireless now. That'll work. We have energy technologies that work with, you know, work in ways that, you know, I mean, look at our ships. We can ride these gravity waves or go through wormholes and stuff. We can do move all over the place in this universe. So you know, we must be able to. We figured out how to finally project guilt onto time space processes, form, and then kill it off. And sure, you have. And you're an example of that, really? Where's the freshness? Huh? What freshness? I asked them, hey, CCC, what saints do you revere? And, could you tell me about the saints that you know, freshness, appearance of normalcy? And they said, no, we don't really have any. No, we don't have that. We don't need that. We don't have that. I said, really? Really? No examples? You can't even tell me one example, huh? No. The universe is just the way that it is, you know, and it's just, we're just working within the nature of what we have here, and that's how it is. We don't need any of that stuff. Ah, I say, really? Okay. So that explains, you know, where they're at. They think that they're going to find the holy grail of successful projection of guilt and sacrifice of it. Or the claim that has already been successfully accomplished. Right now, we just need to enjoy it. The problem is, it's already been successfully accomplished. We're just not, we don't know how to live right and enjoy. This is another tactic they take. Once you learn to really, travel around and go places, everything will be fine. You don't need to. It's already accomplished. It's already done. We did it. It's done and done for us somehow. And just this universe has already accomplished it. And we just need to learn to enjoy our lives here and have happy lives, and everything's fine. But when you experience this freshness, this is something different. This is way better. Wow. This is what I really want. This other stuff of, hey, let's go vacation on the moon or something. Nah, that's ridiculous. I mean, the freshness is what I really want. And the CCC isn't giving it to me. They don't have a clue. They're clueless. I'm not going to go with cluelessness. Not when I have those who've already clued me in. Why should I go with cluelessness? This is a question you need to ask yourself, right? Why should I go with cluelessness when I already have been clued in to what I really want and I know I can get it, actually? I'm not going to go along with cluelessness. That's absurd. That would be a completely absurdly whimsical, totally impaired reason. An impaired reason is not likely to reach any result other than impaired result. And then use impaired reason to claim that the impaired result is the result it really wants, which is just circular, magical thinking, right? So, to the extent that anyone here in this world can allow freshness, except it's just rooted in itself, then the freshness will be present for us. And just full stop and the wow, that is our practice. That is our tradition. That is our discipline. Moment by moment, full stop and the wow is our tradition. Our discipline right now, that is... That's all there is. That's what we're rooted in. We're rooted in full stop in the wow right now. And that is only a temporary rootedness, so to speak. As we know, we'll move our camp even closer. We're rooted in no spin. We're rooted in rootlessness. Thanks for watching. I appreciate it. It's all appreciated. We have to stay motivated. I hate to end this video because this is, we're on a roll right now. This is so important, I'm even missing Giants Fan Fest for this. How about that? You have some dedication, there you go. I'm not even paying any attention to Giant Fan Fest, which is today, which all good Giant fans are very eagerly looking forward to, And I said, hey, I blew it off. I said, now, first I'll tape, and if the taping goes well, I'll continue taping. This is more important. Freshness is its own tradition, actually. Freshness is rooted in the tradition of freshness. freshness is rooted in the tradition of freshness. And nowhere else. Freshness is its own tradition. Some soft rain falling now. It's very nice. Just sitting here in the no spin zone of wow. Problem is when you stop taping and you start talking with people, interacting, to the spin. How do you stay in the freshness of it, of this no spin zone of just wow? Idea just occurred to me. You know, if the freshness was here, where would you meet? And I just said, why not meet in a church, a Catholic church that open all day, and or any church just open all day. Nobody, but a Catholic church, nobody asks you any questions at all. You could just go in the pews and just sit there, and you could feel the freshness and the wow. The problem is the wow can get so intense that you don't want to go anywhere or do anything or talk to anybody or anything. You just want to keep sitting there. And the thing in a Catholic church, nobody would ask you questions. It's just, you know, you're just sitting there, and they say, oh, they're praying. Okay, they're see. And you could stay there for hours and hours. Where else could you do that? You know, that's interesting. Very interesting. And having already done this for, I don't know, 6-7 years of attending Catholic Mass, I don't let anything there, doesn't affect me, it doesn't touch me at all, affect me at all in terms of trying to hook it into some tradition or anything, no. So just for me, I mean, it's just like, it doesn't matter where freshness is, it can be anywhere, but if you're like sitting in some outside nature, people are going to bother you, Ray Park Rangers are going to come, if you're sitting in some suburban house, you know, people come back and you'd have dinner and stuff like that. And it's just like, of course, if you're in a Catholic church, Mass can happen. Of course, if you're in the back, you can just sit there and not do anything. There are some people who just sit and don't get up, sit down, don't even participate. Quite a few people come simply for prayer there, actually. They don't even come for the Mass or anything. No, it's just quiet prayer. There's some churches that are open all night, 24 hours a day, and you can just come, and people come to pray the rosary or come to pray or whatever like that, and you just come and you just sit there. But the issue is, how do you keep this wow from losing the wow and having all the spin of the world start spinning? That is an interesting question. It's always troubled me. Well, where do you go? I can't find anywhere. you sit in the car somewhere, people say, hey, you want, what's, why are you sitting there? Policeman, why are you sitting there all night? You're sitting there in the car, like, are you okay? You know, let me show you, show me your identification or anything. Nobody in a church, nobody asks you for identification. I've never been asked for anything. I've been there 6, 7 years straight, and I've never been asked for anything. Who are you? What's your name? What's your belief? No one's asked me anything in a Catholic church. So this I respect. This I respect. Nobody's even asked me if I'm Catholic, which I'm not. I just go to the Eucharist, I just cross my arms, and they say, bless you, the Holy Spirit bless you, and they get blessings, very nice blessings. Nobody's ever asked me, well, are you Catholic? No, never. And that I respect, that I respect. Some people hold meetings, you know, just in office buildings, or so it's just fine, but they have to rent to pay the rent for those. And or they have in some church where the ideology is, you know, or some bookstore where there's all these books and tapestries and posters that, you know, of Eastern religion. And that, you know, that puts a lot of spin, and you can't stay there forever. It's commercial, somewhat commercial. You feel pressure, but in church, you don't feel like you have to do anything actually there. You don't even have to give money. A lot of people there don't give any money. They go to Mass. I look at the basket that things passed, and there's very little in it actually. And a lot of people don't give anything. And a lot of people who are new there come in, new, never been there before, and they're perfectly welcome. Nobody says, hey, can you please identify yourself and stand up and tell us what you're about, and blah, 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 blah. That's frowned upon, actually. You have every right to be anonymous there. They understand you could be some from outside their tradition, and you're just coming to maybe look and see what they're doing, or you maybe just want to pray, and they're saying, it's fine, you're perfectly welcome to do that. So these things I do respect. Okay, absolutely, but I'm not trying to put the freshness into the Catholic tradition at all. Not trying to do that at all. It'll burst, the wineskins will burst, for sure. But, pragmatically, I do respect this allowance, hands-off allowance. You want to be commune with the divine, you're always welcome here, no questions asked. You know, and they live that. They do live it. It's not just rhetoric. They do live that. At least the feeling in California, I get. You are welcome. Doesn't matter who you are. We know you too are a child of God. So, maybe that's liberal Catholicism. I don't know. It's possible. That idea just popped into my head. Because you don't have to pay. I can't pay for. I don't need money. I can't pay for rent. You know. I can't say, hey, people. Help, we need to pay rent some office building or some meeting place or something. I can't afford that. And a lot of people probably in this time can't afford it anyway. And if economic times go the way that they're likely to go, maybe nobody would be able to afford that. And the thing is, the freshness is, you can feel it just, you know, at a distance. I mean, it's powerful. You don't have to have some guru on a dais, raised dais there, giving satsang, and everybody focusing on that. I need to focus in on their eyes. I need to get the freshness from their eyes. No. When freshness is present, it's like radiating in all directions freely. It's just there. The presence is there. You can't even. There's not even a center to it, really. No, it's everywhere, and it's in a large distance. It's just like a globe or something, an orb, a big globe, a big sun, as it were, a sun of freshness. And it's felt at a distance, very much so. You don't have to have some guru up on a stage saying it's coming from me and you need to look into my eyes and focus on me. No, you can just have the one who has accepted freshness sitting in a pew, and people all throughout the church can feel it, actually. You can be sitting anywhere. You don't even have to be sitting right next to them. You can be 10 pews away or 20 or whatever. You don't have to be looking at them. You don't have to be staring in their eyes or anything. No, you do not have to even. You can just have your eyes closed, actually. You can just be like this. You can just be sitting there feeling it. That's it. So you can have a whole bunch of people go into a church, church pews, different areas of a church, and just sit there. And they're going to be feeling it. So you don't need to make a song and dance of it, actually. Did not. That's trying to put new wine into old wineskins in the tradition. That's what traditions have worked out. We need to do this and this and that. And that's not necessary at all. For instance, Normal Anandamayi would go to all these religious festivals and functions. And she often just sit on the ground over in the corner. That's it. They say, oh, come on up here in front. She says, no. And she'd just lean against a wall on the ground, just wrapped in the sheet that they wear, the white sari, and just lean against a wall with her eyes closed and just sit there like that. And meanwhile, the functions would be going on, and the learned pundits would be pontificating, and but everybody would feel like this intense sanctity there. Intense sanctity. She wouldn't draw any attention. Normal Anandamayi, you would draw no attention to the fact that this is the normalcy is because of the acceptance of normalcy. In this case. Because the presence of it would just be super saturating the whole area. The whole area. And it doesn't, it doesn't need for anything specialness to make its appearance or anything like that, no. Now, there may be some churches and various people who might want to invite you and say, would you please come and just sit here. Like that's possible. If they try to spin it into a tradition, then you say, no, that doesn't work. We're just full stop in the wow of this. But there might be some places like that who just say, would you please come? And we want to just sit in silence here. Okay, that's possible. Yeah. Might be some places open to that. There probably would be. So, that's good. I'm seeing some hope here, some optimism. I don't want to be sitting up on some stage or something, or whoever is the freshness. I'm just using myself as an example here, but, no, why? I don't want to have a bunch of people, some cults around you looking at you. You're the answer. You're the answer. No. That's not it. I want everyone to full stop in the wow, which is an intense discipline. They need to be sitting there. They need to be concentrating on no spin. Full stop in the wow. Wow, this is the freshness. This is the real. This is the fresh freshness. And wow. And concentrate on that. Concentrate on your own. Full stop in the wowness of your wow-mindedness. I'm not trying to establish some tradition of here's the big guru and here's how this and this and this and this and this. No, we're trying to get to the freshness. We're transitioning to normalcy here. It's interesting in Catholic Mass, that people, everyone's sitting down, they're looking at the altar area, and before it starts, the priest is actually in the back of a building. Everyone has their back to the priest, and they're looking up there. And so the priest gradually walks up, a loping processional, and then takes the place, so they're just officiating over this. But, everyone's not looking at the priest like, oh, well, we gotta follow the priest, we gotta watch the priest. No. You're supposed to be in prayer. You're supposed to be focused on prayer. So there are some good aspects to those situations. I'm just noticing that and applying it, say, hey, you don't have to have some big guru up on a stage. No way. Just have a sit one of the crowd just sitting there, just sit there. If someone is in accepted normalcy and freshness, they just sit with everyone else, just sit there. No one has to be looking at them, and there's all just maybe we're just looking at a nice neutral spot. Not tying into tradition necessarily, or whatever it is, it's okay. It's just some space there. However it's configured doesn't really matter, because we're just focusing on the wow of this. This is wow. This is no joke. Feeling the freshness is wow, because it's rooted in freshness. And this is like out of this world. You realize, wow, this is out of this world. This is what I really want. And it just, you just have to feel you're allowed to concentrate on that wow, and somebody's not going to come up and hustle you for your identity or something. Say, what are you doing here? Explain yourself. What's your tradition? What's your deal? You know, we can't have people come up and say, well, what's your deal? You just stay in the wow. See, so it's not a personality cult. That is not it. That's avoiding it. What's it? It's your own discipline. It's your own wowism. That's it. It's your own wowism. That is it. It's your own determination to full stop in the wow and get used to it. That's what's it. That's all that there is. That is it. So we're doing our best here. Hey, the world needs help. There's no question about it. There are many, many that need help. There's no question about it. But they have to understand what it's all about, so they don't end up with their wheels coming off. It's about your own discipline. It's not worshiping someone else's discipline. It's about your own discipline. Get up from this wow. It's like, you know, wow, it's like transitioning back into, it's like being in air conditioning, walking outside into the tropical, humid, you know, humid, hot humidity of the tropics. It's like in the desert, it's 113 degrees, and you're in the air-conditioned hotel, and you walk out of that, and it kaboom. And you say, hey, I don't really want to walk out of this air-conditioned hotel. Not yet. So it's really helpful to, you know, if things are over and the taping here and stuff, you might want to just keep sitting quietly for an hour or two. Just let this sink in. Just stay quiet time. I don't feel like driving right now. I don't feel like this. That's super helpful, actually. Super helpful. Very helpful. Otherwise, you're going to be afraid to let the wow really hit you, because you say, oh my gosh, I don't really want to, I need some time to let this sink in. And you think you have to jump back into the caffeinated jet stream of modern insanity, then that's a problem. So, we got to be pragmatic here. We got to be very intelligently pragmatic and not get hung up on stuff. That is for sure. And we're trying our best here. All right, very great. That's it for this one. Full stop in the wow.